Guys, we're talking about cars today.
If you have followed along in your Chalk Talk readers over the past decade plus that Chalk Talk has been on the air, you will know that I love anything that has to do with the open road, the wind in my hair, and nothing in my way, except the occasional speeding ticket. And it goes without saying that innovation in the world of automotive designs has certainly picked up speed in my lifetime, but especially in the last decade. And now we have camera systems, LED lighting, infotainment, high-speed Ethernet, driver assistance. We're practically driving around in little data centers. And in order to keep up with this fast-paced innovation, we really need to take a closer look at every part of our systems, all the way down to the connectors. Hi, I'm Amelia Dalton, host of Chalk Talk. In terms of automotive design, connectivity and automation are going to play bigger and bigger roles going forward, and choosing the right connectors can make a big difference. In this episode of Chalk Talk, Glenn Heath from Amphenol ICC joins me to discuss the changing landscape for automotive applications, the evolution of front lighting in particular, and how the Minitek MicroSpace connector can help your design get to market in 0 to 60. All right, let's go. And before we get started, don't forget to click that link. There you can find even more information about the Minitek MicroSpace connector. Hi, Glenn. Thank you so much for joining me.
Hi, thanks, Amelia.
Okay, so we're talking about cars today, which is one of my favorite subjects here at EE Journal. But before we jump into the details of today's Chalk Talk, let's walk through how exactly we got to where we are today in the automotive market.
The car represents an object that's really become fundamental over time. We've seen incredible and diverse innovations that make the automotive market one of the most interesting markets for technological development. If we think about the history of the car, from that famous date of January 29, 1886, when patent number 37435 was filed for the car, first powered by an internal combustion engine, to the early decades of the 1900s, where the economic growth of countries such as the U.S. saw the birth of new industries, including the Ford Motor Company. Its founder, Henry Ford, decided to design and market a Model T, a low-cost car accessible to all, giving way to the phenomenon of the car for all. Leaping forward to today, the car is considered a means of transportation, but with the maximum possible comfort and safety. So we're living in the middle of a rapid evolution from a traditional internal combustion engine vehicle to a hybrid electric vehicle, and then into a fully electric vehicle. And in the near future, it'll fully evolve into a completely autonomous vehicle. So the world of automotive that we've been experiencing in recent years and the next generation mobility will be defined by a safer and more sustainable green vision for a better and safer world.
I like the sound of that. Glenn, what do you see are the biggest market drivers and trends pushing innovation in this space?
Well, first, there's regulations. Legislation is a major driver of the industry. Governments in many countries have imposed strict environmental regulations, dealing with fuel economy and emissions that auto manufacturers must follow. And additionally, recycling legislation has a strong impact both on vehicle technologies and construction. This has a huge impact on global auto manufacturers, as they must keep updating the products they sell in different parts of the world to comply with these regulations. Then there's technological innovations. Technology influences the construction of a vehicle that complies with those environmental regulations and the safety systems driven by regulations or by consumer demand. And of course, globalization of the automotive industry has greatly accelerated during the last half of the 90s due to the construction of important overseas facilities and mergers between giant multinational automakers. The world's largest automotive manufacturers invest in production facilities in emerging markets in order to reduce production costs, and in some cases, they established commercial strategic partnerships with other automobile manufacturers. Then we can't forget consumer interest and demand. Consumers' preferences become more and more varied and demanding, creating interest in both new external design and new technological advancements. And finally, there's economic conditions. These have a strong impact on the market trend. When the economic conditions are favorable, people are more likely to buy new vehicles, giving momentum to the sector. Therefore, producers must take into account the market trends in order to achieve economies of scale.
So, Glenn, where specifically does Amphenol ICC play in all of this?
you can imagine, it's difficult to show all of this, but in the car, we have many applications with a high level of technology and connection. In addition to the advanced driver assistance systems, or ADAS, we see Ethernet, body control, safety, security and comfort, head and interior LED lighting, cameras to eliminate blind spots, multimedia infotainment, GPS, and many other electronic features. All of this requires more connectors and cables in the car.
Okay, cool. Now, I know that connectivity and automation is going to play a bigger and bigger role moving forward in the automotive industry as a whole. Is this something you've seen as well?
We have seen that. Amphenol recognizes that automotive development is continuing in the direction of having increasing technologies and maximum safety criteria. Cars have more systems to safeguard human life and to minimize the risk of accidents than ever before. We see more cars produced with advanced driver assistance systems, or ADAS, with passive assistance services, including lane departure warning, autonomous emergency braking, and advanced city assistance. The FCI Basics Group brings a broad array of innovative technology and solutions to support the growth in the automotive industry, particularly in plating, signal integrity performance, and power management. As the automotive become more ADAS rich and head toward being a total autonomous operation, the key differentiator between suppliers will be their quality, their capabilities, and their performance. Amphenol has the global quality, disciplines, and commitment to meet the demands and requirements of all these new technologies.
Okay, cool. Now, Glenn, let's dig into the lighting aspect you mentioned earlier. It seems like front lighting has changed a lot over the last couple years.
Absolutely. A technical revolution started in the front lighting thanks to LED technology, which opened a huge horizon to car manufacturers to increase the added value and options of this formerly simple application. We went from manually switching from low beams to high beams as needed, to automatization of that headlight switching, to side lighting when turning, and to fully automatic adaptive front lighting. The adaptive lighting can now control up to 1 million LEDs, and with the support of a camera, it can manage the light beam intensity and direction to avoid blinding other drivers and brightening areas to increase the visibility for the driver. And in the near future, those systems will also project roadside navigation information like speed limits and warnings of a potential danger or risk. In the FCI Basics product portfolio, we have a product line that was originally launched to answer this specific trend within the front headlight technological advancements. The automotive Minitek MicroSpace product line has been developed to support the trend of miniaturization in the car industry, starting at the front lighting.
Okay, cool. So Glenn, explain to me a little bit more, how does connectivity come into play here?
The consequence of those new lighting functionalities is an increasing number of signals to be controlled, from the lighting ECU driver to the lamp modules, as we can control each LED independently from the others for the adaptive front lights. That means this has a direct consequence in terms of number of connections and wires, but the constraint in the car industry remains the same. We have to reduce the space used and simultaneously meet the design requirements. We also need to reduce the weight for better fuel economy, despite the increasing number of wires. And on top of that, with the automatization of the lighting, the level of connection liability increases drastically. So a paramount requirement has to be quality and reliability. In the past, the driver decided when to switch the headlights to high beams and had full control of that decision. With the automatic lighting, it's the car that'll ensure the best visibility. Any malfunction could put the driver in a critical situation. Because of this, the car manufacturers are now driving the choice of the electronics, including the connector content, and insist on very strict specifications. For instance, for connectors, most of the car manufacturers require an LV214 Severity 2 qualification. And for the U.S. markets, a U.S. Car 2 qualification. In the past, the suppliers of front lighting solutions were choosing their connector solution from the non-automotive market, as there were no automotive qualified connector solutions available for small pitch, like 1.27 millimeter. The market driver was more cost than any industry standards. Today, automotive industry standards are requiring features like terminal positioning assurance to ensure the correct position and retention of the crimp terminal in the housing, or the connector position assurance to ensure that the connectors are well mated in the final position to avoid any accidental activation of the connector latching. Those standards also provide specifications in terms of the mechanical performance, electrical performance, and quality of performance to achieve. All those standards are key to successfully offering a connector solution, which will be reliable over the lifetime of the car and will ensure the safety of the passengers. The smaller the connector, the more these specifications become difficult challenges for connector design. It's in this field that Amphenol is providing all the technical advantages coming from different markets to push innovative solutions.
Very cool. Now, Glenn, let's talk a little bit more about Minitek MicroSpace. What does it really buy me as an engineer?
Earlier, I mentioned that all the functionality and all those standards didn't specifically mean that auto manufacturers were now providing more space or allowing more weight. When we focus on size, the driver is the connector pitch. For small connector systems, the most popular pitches had previously been 1.8 millimeters and above. Going to finer pitch means decreasing the size of crimp terminals, which has consequences to the electrical performance. So the challenge is to propose the best compromise between size and electrical performance. Our product, Minitek MicroSpace, for instance, offers one of the smallest pitches in the car industry at 1.27 millimeters on the PCB. It keeps optimal electrical performance thanks to a staggered design, which allows the use of wires up to 22 gauge. And then to answer the weight constraint, which is mainly driven by the cable itself, our product is offered with different crimp terminal options compatible with wires from 22 gauge down to 28 gauge. That means the customer can choose the smallest and lightest wire fitting their electrical requirement with the same connector solution.
All right, Glenn, this has been a lot to take in today. Can you recap your main points for me?
We offer the highest electrical performance through advances in plating finishes, power management, and signal integrity. While other products on the market still utilize up to 1.8 millimeter pitch, our Minitek MicroSpace staggered 1.27 millimeter product will offer the performance in a very small package with terminal positioning assurance to prevent bent pins and to ensure cable retention of the crimped terminal. Based on the design constraint of the application, we can offer either top latch or side latch, vertical or horizontal orientation, all of which offer the connector positioning assurance. We offer both a wire-to-board type and a wire-to-wire type. We will also launch a sealed product line this year. And we have a series that is LV214 qualified, and we're currently launching a new series, which will be both LV214 and US car fully qualified. So our Minitek MicroSpace delivers all of these features in one simple solution. And we really appreciate you giving us the chance to introduce it today.
Absolutely. Well, Glenn, I think that's all I have time for today. Thank you so much for joining me.
Thank you.
And before we go, you didn't forget to click that link, did you? There you can find even more information about Amphenol ICC's Minitek MicroSpace Connector. For Chalk Talks, I'm Amelia Dalton from eejournal.com. For more Chalk Talks, head on over to the Chalk Talk section of EE Journal. You can't miss it. It's right across the top. Or head on over to YouTube, youtube.com/EEJournal.